Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome Mr. Karan Bhatia.
Thank you. Is this the clicker that will work? So, since morning, we've been hearing two things, gas and cylinders. So, to liven things up a little bit more, my piece or my presentation is going to be more photos and less data and graphs and things like that, just to lighten it up and, just to make it easy for everybody to understand. So, my topic today is on efficient and safe alternative fuel mobility. Safety is the most important part of any cylinder manufacturer. If one cylinder goes wrong, the entire industry gets blamed, and a lot of innocent people die because of that. So that's the reason that this gas cylinder is under the Explosives Act of Government of India, and that's why the Department of Explosives, or now called PESO, looks after these cylinders. So that's just to give you a little background of why the petroleum and explosives people look after cylinders. The one thing they are designed to do is not to explode. So just to tell you about the Luxfer group. So Luxfer Uttam India is a joint venture between Luxfer and Uttam. And if you see on this screen, we have different locations. We make cylinders that are made out of aluminium as well as composites. So we actually make type 1, type 2, type 3, and type 4 cylinders. What is good? What is not good, they all serve a purpose. My challenge to you is that, do you know what you need? You may hear people saying, this is better, that is better. It is horses for courses. And that's what I'm trying to maybe, expand on it a little more, is please go into a little more depth of what, these cylinders are. What does it mean? It's not an iPhone. That one, two, three, and four. If you have the four, then you have the latest version. No, that is not what it means. Type three basically means it's a cylinder with a metal liner. Metal could be a steel liner, it could be an aluminum liner, it could be a titanium liner. Any metallic liner, a cylinder wrapped is type three. And a non-metallic liner, plastic, different grades of plastic, they all qualify as basically a type 4. So I'm going to show you some products that we kind of put together. This is really slow. Okay, I'm going to just open all of them up. So if you see, you've got cylinders that are for natural gas vehicles. These are basically for onboard use on the extreme left or the top left. Then you've got natural gas systems wherein you put in all the cylinders, pipe them up, put the valve, put the safety disc to the burst discs, and then you have, the system. Then you've got cylinder bulk hauling for gases, from point A to point B. Doesn't necessarily need to be natural gas, it could be any gas, it could be helium, it could be hydrogen, it could be nitrogen, it could be oxygen. Then there are onboard use for hydrogen, and in the middle, you see this container is basically what is there for our bulk gas transport units, and I'll show you some more pictures on this a little later on. These are few examples of different kind of vehicles that have been built by us and our partners, whether it's for transit, vocation, light, medium duty. And like my friend from Worthington was saying that, you have these cylinders which are, 40-foot ones. These pictures are not, of course, not Indian pictures, but I'll show you some more. So these ones are the type 3 cylinders that are there. And if you see that photograph in the middle of Tata Motors, Tata Motors has used these type 3 cylinders in India. and they have never had an issue with them. They've run thousands of kilometers on these cylinders. So we work with a lot of, you know, well-known brands, which you can see. I'm not going to, you know, read them out, but you can see that we work with several players from Europe to the US to India to everywhere. These are for hydrogen. Now, if you see that picture in the middle, it's not a picture from Europe, it's not a picture from America, it is a picture from India. This, we worked together with Tata Motors to develop their first 5 prototypes of their hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. There was a learning curve involved because hydrogen is very different from natural gas. Natural gas is a forgiving gas. If I can say relatively, hydrogen is not a forgiving gas. So with the slightest of issue, you know, you can have lots of problems. So that's the reason there's a lot of processes required before you can do the first fill, and the level of cleanliness required is very, very high. So this is what we've done for, Tata Motors. I'll show you some more pictures of hydrogen systems that we've done. So we've done work with Mahindra, and for CNG, normally for onboard use you use 200 bar, but for transporting it on a bulk gas transport unit, we use 250 bar. But in hydrogen, the standard is 350 bar. So why I'm mentioning this is because if you see in Mahindra, they use an internal combustion engine that runs on hydrogen. But in Tata, they used a hydrogen fuel cell system. So we've worked on both sides of the, you know, the spectrum of, for hydrogen powered vehicles. Now I'm going to come to the bulk gas transport systems. I'll show you a little video of our factory in India. These are, of course, two different options. One is the modules, which are 10-footer modules, which you can put four together, and you have a 40-foot range. Then you have these refuelers, which are not currently being used in India, but by this you can kind of drain everything, because our gas pipeline head pressure is about 40 bar, 30 bar. But for that, you know, we don't have the system, so 30-40 bar is always left in the cylinder. But with refuelers, you can get it down to at a much lower thing. And if you see the one on the right, the portable generators, this is using hydrogen fuel cells to give light where there is no power available. So hydrogen is converted to hydrogen fuel cell fuel, and from there it gives the power. So for disasters or places where there's no power available, this is a solution that is there. We are currently working with the Indian Army as well for this. I'm going to play a small video now. This is about our factory in Faridabad, where we manufacture these containment systems. We currently don't build, we produce type 1 aluminium, pure aluminium cylinders in India. But for the type 3, we import them and we kind of assemble them together at our place. I'm going to brief video will show you how we assemble them, how we load it, and how we move it. Do I have to press something? Maybe you can use it from the other one which you were playing earlier. Okay, so while this comes on, let's come back to this type 3 and type 4 which we were making. Are you guys ready? So I'm going to just show you some photos. This is a typical steel cascade cylinders which we have all been used to seeing on the roads. This one is what the new system looks like. It looks different. The cylinders are not exposed, the piping is not exposed. It is a much more stronger and a more robust system because it is designed for something. There are no rules in India for high pressure, inflammable gases, containment. There are rules for cylinders. But how you package it together, how you connect it together, to what crash test you should belong to, or what class of testing it should belong to, there are no rules. And here we are talking about building an infrastructure all over India with crores and thousands of crores, hundreds of thousands of crores, and we don't have some basic rules around moving this system there. That's how we are. I feel that our country moves with jerks. Supreme Court gave a jerk, saying that now you need CNG, so everybody's running around CNG. That was a jerk. Commonwealth Games happened in Delhi. At that time, like I was saying in the morning, the Delhi Transport Corporation was under pressure to buy 3,000 buses. Because why? Commonwealth Games were happening. We had approvals for composite cylinders even there. We went to Delhi Transport Corporation, explained it to them that, this is the advantage and you'll carry more gas. You'll carry 65% more gas. There'll be lighter weight. This is your advantage. That is your advantage. But there was a pressure from the High Court. So and under pressure from the, the vehicle manufacturers who used to make the buses, Tata and Leyland, they said, okay, we can't deliver this with these composite cylinders because we've never worked with them before. So based on that, DTC changed their specifications. Whose loss was it? Today their buses are breaking down more because there are too much weight in the bus. Secondly, they're carrying less gas and they have to do more refueling. Third, they're out of Delhi, business has gone. They don't do Chandigarh, they don't go out of Delhi because now they can't go and come back. I even met the chief minister of Delhi at that time, Sheila Dixit. And I told her, ma'am, that this is what's happened and that's what happened. After hearing me out, she said that, do you think I will be elected chief minister of Delhi to sell your cylinders? So I replied, I said, no, ma'am, you've been elected to do the right thing. And this is the right thing. And what's happened, what's changed is not the right thing. Long story short, nothing happened. Hopefully they learned their lesson. And going forward, they'll probably, buy the right technology that's for them. So in this particular one, if you see the one on the top, this has a max capacity, it's a 10-ton vehicle. But it has a water liter capacity of 4,500 liter water capacity. Now, they carry 600 kg of gas. The reason is they can carry more. But the reason they don't carry more, because they don't fill it beyond 220 bar. These are designed to be filled to 270 bar, and then you have a settle pressure of 250 bar. Because when you fill a cylinder, it heats up, and when it settles down, it cools down. So you should have a 250 bar. But when you fill in 220 bar, you have a settle pressure of 200 bar. And the cylinder comes back with 30 bar of pressure. So effectively what you've done is you've only transported 170 bar. Whose loss is it? It's the CGD company's loss. And the reason they do it is because there's a valid reason for them to do it. Because these systems do not use, they use something called as a pressure relief device, which is a fusible mass. That if there is excess pressure, it will blow. The problem is that when it's supposed to blow, it doesn't blow. When it's not supposed to blow, it blows. So over a period of time, people have kind of negotiated with this that 250 bar tak chalta hai, 220 bar tak chalta hai. Between 220 bar to 250 bar pe kabhi bhi ye ud jayega. So that's the logic that is there. Now what we use in our systems, and which I would encourage all the other people to do it, because it doesn't matter whether you use a type 1, type 2, type 3 or type 4, is to use something called the temperature pressure relief device, a TPRD, which is not purely a pressure relief device, but it works on the temperature as well. Because if there's a fire, the cylinder pressure will rise, and at some point in time, you know, the safety should blow. But if it doesn't blow, the cylinder will blow. In a TPRD, what happens is that once it reaches a certain temperature, it'll give way, irrespective of whether the pressure reaches there or not. So it's a much, much, much safer device to use. So that's the reason, you know, they kind of carry more. We have tested this physically in a lot of gas companies. And we said, we will do the first fill in front of us. You fill it, our people are standing on top of the bulk gas transport unit, and nothing will happen. You fill it to 270 bar, and you get a 250 bar settle pressure. With this, what they were able to do, instead of 4,500 liter water capacity, because it's lighter, it can carry more gas and less weight. So we are able to fit in a 8,800 liter water capacity, which is practically double the water capacity. And that is where they get the savings of more than 50% in their, their transportation. This, if filled to its full pressure, will have 1,500 kilograms of gas that you can transport. And the basic advantage is that, you know, the current systems that are being used are steel. The Type 3 cylinders that are there, they have an aluminium liner. Now, aluminium is far more resistant to rust than steel is. And also, if there is a water impurity, a lot of, you know, compressors are water cooled. So if there's water penetration in a steel cylinder, it'll corrode it. But in an aluminium, it does not corrode. Why? Because aluminium is more resistant to water than steel is. So I'm going to show you some pictures of the bulk gas transports that we've used, and we've got, I'm happy to say, you know, they are very satisfied customers, and I'll be more than willing for you to give them, you know, contact them, hear them, what their experiences is. So the first one was Savaria Gas. I saw Mr. H.P. Singh sitting here somewhere. I don't know where he is right now. But he was one of our first customers who kind of did this, and I thank him for, you know, having the leadership to come ahead and do it by the time where people were still dwindling with what to do. Now we have, this is a unit that is running in Gujarat Gas. Then there is in MNGL, Maharashtra Natural Gas, Mahanagar Gas. Okay. This is IRM, this is a company based out of Ahmedabad that is into the gases business. This is the unit running at their end. This is running at Torrent or Mahesh Gas. Then, now if you see this Savaria Gas picture, it's a very interesting photo. If you see, they are using a 20-foot container, and there's space left, so they put a steel container as well. Very similar to what, you know, you were talking about earlier, but yes, people are doing this. Then there's one running in Ashoka Buildcon, which is 2 10-footers put together. These are all pictures from India running very successfully. This is the recent one that was launched by Indraprastha Gas. There is something unique about this. What is unique is that Indraprastha Gas wanted a truck to carry CNG, which the truck itself should be CNG. And there was no truck in that category where, you know, it was powered by CNG. So Tata actually built a unit for us. Not for us really, but really for IGL. Now this is our CNG powered vehicle carrying CNG. How cool is that? Because most of the other ones are transporting CNG, but they're not running on CNG. This one, if you see the one, these are the 4 units, these are 40-footer units. These are running for Mega. They are at an ONGC site, transporting gas from point A to point B. So these act as a virtual gas pipeline, where there is no pipeline, you can actually deploy high, size products for this. So question is, again, I'm going to end my talk on type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, or type 5. You know, there's a type 5 as well. Nobody talks about that. Why? Because it's a technology that's really not proven itself yet. So please don't, it's like I said, it's a gas cylinder. It's an industrial product. It's not something based on a model of a phone. There, one is, two is better than one, and three is better than two, and four is better than three. You need to know what your need is. You need to know what your operating conditions are. You need to know what the right product suits you. We make all four. I can tell you the advantages, disadvantages, one-on-one, whoever wants to, you know, to have a topic, a discussion on that. We've seen in terms of pricing, people say that type 3 is more expensive, type 4 is cheaper. Our experience is till the time you make a 16-inch diameter cylinder, the cost difference between type 3 and type 4 is negligible. It's only when you go to the 22-inch cylinders, which are used for high-capacity commercial trucks, heavy-duty trucks, that's the time that there is a distinct advantage between type 4 to type 3 in terms of price, because it's just that the pipe, the metallic pipe, exponentially goes up when you go beyond 16-inch diameter. But till 16-inch diameter, which is what used in the bulk gas transport, which is what is used for automotive fuel, they are pretty competitive. And of course, it's metal versus plastic, and I'll let you guys decide. Like I said, we make both horses for courses for whoever wants to choose. I'm around for any questions. Thank you very much.